Hi, I'm Ben Miller from the University of Sydney. My colleague Denny Liu and I are presenting some short videos for TEXA about the current state of generative AI tools and the way they can be used in teaching, learning, and assessment. Denny has looked at how generative AI can be used to complete online quizzes, create multimedia presentations, and even draw on course material to create scripts or essays. This video tackles reflective writing, an important form of academic writing that is being used more frequently now as a response to generative AI. And in another video, Denny will consider how generative AI tools raise questions about the veracity of online presentations and interviews. Reflective writing is close to the heart of many educators, creating a relevant and personalized learning experience for many students. Some educators suggest that setting reflective writing tasks lowers the incidence of students using generative AI. The concern here is that when a teacher says the use of AI is low, what they're really saying is the use of AI I can detect is low, and there are limits to what we can detect. In reflective writing, people tend to look for supposedly human elements like descriptions of feelings or anecdotes about real people as markers of a text created without AI. But the reality is that freely available tools used with high quality prompts produce reflective writing that is indistinguishable from reflective writing created before Gen AI was widely available. Research by Lee et al. Not only showed this, but also showed that the Gen AI text, which could not be identified by humans, was created by a version of ChatGPT that's now considered a legacy model, with more powerful versions available for free and even more powerful versions available for about US$22 per month. But the quality of the prompt matters. What happens when a student's prompting skills prevent them from creating high-quality reflective writing? Well, maybe they get caught out by teachers keen on detecting or punishing the use of generative AI. Or maybe they can pay to overcome their disadvantage. Some AI tools, like HyperWrite, cost about AU$20 per month and are designed to streamline prompting. Within the HyperWrite platform, users can select from a range of tools that target specific genres or skills. One content rewriting agent in HyperWrite has been used over 470,000 times. An expert writing assistant within HyperWrite has been used over 150,000 times. When a tool is selected, users go to an interface that asks for input, which is then woven into a behind-the-scenes prompt and run through a large language model like ChatGPT to generate a more expertly guided response than the user might have created with their own basic prompting skills. Or perhaps, even if they have good prompting skills, if they're too rushed to design a quality prompt on their own. The Academic Essay Writer tool, which has been running on your screen while I've been talking, has here created an essay with real scholarly sources. Another tool within HyperWrite offers writing camouflage, which modifies text entered by the user to avoid detection by common detection tools. Here on your screen, I've copied the text from the Academic Essay Writer, entered it into the camouflage tool, and very subtle changes have been made to raise the text's burstiness and perplexity, meaning there is less predictable sequences in word-to-word and sentence-to-sentence level combination. This appears more random, which tricks detection platforms into thinking that the text was created without a large language model. Tools like HyperWrite also provide interfaces that can guide reflective writing. This reflective writing tool provides a template for the prompt, guiding users to enter relevant information. Here, the user describes an event that occurred on a teaching practicum, their reactions, and some basic observations. The tool, with some background prompting that's hidden from us, turns this into a logical, introspective narrative. If the user wanted to draw on research in a critical reflection, they could enter research material. Here, the essay generated just a few moments ago, and then ask the model to interweave the experience-focused text with the research text. Another type of reflective task that has become popular since the advent of generative AI has involved teachers asking students to reflect on the outputs of a large language model. For example, a teacher might provide students with an essay created by ChatGPT or ask students to generate an answer to a disciplinary question using Copilot. If these tasks are supposed to lower the use of generative AI, or if they're designed with the assumption that Gen AI can't reflect on its own outputs, then teachers might be disappointed. Generative AI tools like Microsoft Copilot, which can easily summarize text, can also reflect on its own output. Copilot is available for $33 Australian dollars per month and is available to many Australian university students and staff for free via institutional licenses. Here, we see Copilot creating a summary of a journal article abstract and recommending it to students. A follow-up prompt, based on research by Haik et al., provides criteria for measuring bias and asks Copilot to evaluate its own output. Haik's research actually found that, when comparing evaluations of bias created by humans in isolation with those created by AI models, the AI models identified their own bias more reliably and with more detail. Here, a paid version of ChatGPT, costing about $22 per month, shows that Gen AI is capable of image and artwork analysis. As I add a copyright-free image of graffiti in Newtown, Sydney, and ask it for a description and recommendation. A follow-up prompt is added to the conversation, again based on Haik et al.'s criteria, but you could use a different criteria of bias or ask students to develop their own. And the Gen AI tool evaluates itself and can elaborate when asked for a further explanation. The quality of evaluation, like the quality of reflective writing, depends on the quality of the prompt a user can create. But there are numerous generative AI wrappers that can make up for any shortfall in a user's ability to prompt large language models effectively. Tools like Pro Writing Aid, Jenny AI, Writeful, Thesify, and PaperPal vary in cost, but typically range from 20 to 40 Australian dollars per month. They all provide a service that wraps around or relies upon a large language model like ChatGPT. They hide the work of prompting from users, taking information from users and developing it into prompts, sometimes drawing on access to additional materials like research archives to create a more expert output than the user might be able to generate on their own. These tools are more likely to be used by students who feel there is a gap between their own skills and their peers' skills in using generative AI. Or they might be used when the learning environment adds what is perceived to be too much pressure to do with workload or time or difficulty, or where an activity is not seen as important, relevant, or authentic. Perhaps training students in prompting can level the field a little, which might even make students less susceptible to what have been called predatory platforms. The goal shouldn't be to create assessment with gotcha moments where students are caught out for using AI. Such assessment is likely to harshly penalize students with lower AI literacy, while others with more skill or more money arguably do less work and less learning and sail through without detection. A gap then emerges between those with skills or the means to produce quality AI-generated outputs and those without. Assessment practice that overemphasizes the product of learning, for example, a finished essay or a report or a reflection, will widen the divide with the worrying outcome that students don't need to learn to complete their assessments. Those with better prompts or access to better tools receive better results. Instead, assessment might emphasize the learning process. One example from my field of rhetoric and writing studies, where we aim to teach the writing process, not providing templates for the finished essay or a finished written product, involves students completing a series of interlinked assessments where they explore and investigate the context of an issue and they brainstorm what we call the available means of persuasion or a range of possible arguments that have or can be made on a topic. They draft, share, edit, and improve their writing. Within the context of generative AI tools, assessing the process instead of the product is not about preventing generative AI use, but about ensuring that learning occurs even as generative AI tools are used. And as a bonus, assessing the learning process removes some of the advantages that Gen AI skill and the financial means to access advanced tools provides. When we teach student prompting in the context of a learning process, generative AI tools assist students in seeing some of the available arguments, providing counterpoints, giving feedback, or creating drafts. At each step, the decisions of the students are prioritized. This is one way that we might start to remove suspicion from assessment and evaluation. Stigmatizing Gen AI use and prioritizing detection, after all, presents a serious risk to the kinds of supportive relationships between teachers and students that can ensure learning. At the University of Sydney, we've been focused on the balance between tasks that present an assessment of learning and tasks that provide an assessment for learning. We think that product-focused assessment, which will remain necessary for a whole range of reasons, might best be suited to a form of supervised assessment, which we call Lane 1 assessment. These tasks will be useful for verifying learning outcomes and assuring that students have the skills and knowledge that are core to their disciplines, and might best be set up as hurdle or compulsory tasks. The bulk of assessment will occur in what we call Lane 2. Here, we aim to assess the learning process with tasks that enable practice and scaffolding of the essential skills and knowledge in a program. A brief example of how these different assessment types might be mapped in a small program show that Lane 1 assessments are less frequent, but vitally important in the overall completion of a program. TEXA guidance around assessment talks about both the need to verify the outcomes of learning in secure assessment situations and the need to connect students with generative AI to ensure learning is relevant and graduates are prepared for a future that includes generative AI. At Sydney, Denny and I recently spoke with educators in medicine who are considering the balance between supporting students with Gen AI tools and verifying their learning outcomes. Our colleagues have program-level learning outcomes to ensure graduates are critically reflective medical practitioners. This is a great example of why reflective writing is important and will remain an important academic genre at university. Our colleagues in medicine are working with their eyes wide open about the capacity of Gen AI to mimic reflective writing. But they're also fully aware of how Gen AI can help students reflect on critical incidents and help them adjust their assumptions and their practice. And they're also keen to have some key moments in their curriculum where they can lock down and verify that their graduates possess reflective thinking skills in supervised assessment. So the hard work has begun to map the curriculum, to plan for moments of reflective thinking in assessments throughout the program, and developing a plan for which moments will become times where we verify these skills and which moments will remain open to generative AI use, and students will be guided in the best ways to use Gen AI to develop important reflective skills. The bulk of their assessment might be in Lane 2, where educators support the use of Gen AI. Then in Lane 1, educators will supervise how students practice reflective thinking. So it's not the end of reflective thinking, and it's not the end of the essay or product-focused assessment, but it should be the end of assuming that we can design assessments that Gen AI can't complete. The next step is to return to the principles of good assessment and learning, including relevance, authenticity, process-based learning, and scaffolding support for learning across a program, as we inspire students to learn with assistance from and independently from Gen AI tools.